So in this video, we're gonna dive in a little bit more into the adjustments that are actually being made when we click that auto button. How do we override those to create something a little bit more unique, a little bit more customizable to what our vision might be? So this image I have open here is from a recent shoot we did, the Urban iPhone Photography course, and this is of the Oculus downtown New York City. While this is the photo that you might see in camera, this is the photo I wanted to create. This is the vision that I had, and that's what this course is all about, is not seeing what's immediately in front of you, but seeing what things could be, seeing the potential of a scene and realizing your vision. It doesn't have to be difficult at all. It doesn't have to be complicated. Now, before we jump in and start editing, there's one really crucial thing that I need to show you that's not immediately obvious. The best thing you can do is to make your screen as bright as possible, and every single one of your photos is gonna look better. So let me show you how we do this. We're gonna swipe down from the top right of our screen, and you're gonna see the brightness value slider on the right-hand side there. All you need to do is swipe up on that brightness value to its maximum. This is absolutely critical because we're about to dive into how to adjust the tonal values, your midtones, your whites, and your blacks. And that brightness of your screen is gonna have a big impact. So when you tap and hold, that's gonna bring up an entirely new screen. And here you have the option to turn on and off True Tone. Now this is critical because by default, Apple turns this on for you. And I really think that that wasn't necessarily a good thing to do, because what it does is read the color temperature of the room that you find yourself in and tries to match the color temperature of the screen to that room. So all of the colors that we work on, that we pay careful attention to in our edits, are gonna be slightly off. So what I want you to do is simply click on True Tone. That will turn off that feature, making sure that all of the color in your photos are perfectly neutral. Now there's one other feature here I wanna point your attention to. Now this isn't on by default, but it's really important to understand what it does, and that's Night Shift. If I turn that on, you're gonna see just how warm it makes my screen. Now the reason why they do that is if we find ourselves reading in bed at night, that daylight balance, that neutral color, it stimulates our brain, it keeps us up. So this Night Shift is meant for reading at night. But the problem is if you leave it on and you forget to turn it off, even more than True Tone, all of your colors are gonna be shifted because your screen is intentionally much warmer. So you really wanna be careful and make sure that both of these values are turned off. And now you're working with a very neutral, daylight balanced screen, ensuring that all of your colors are accurate and consistent from photo to photo. So the first step, we're gonna click on the word edit on the top right. That's gonna bring us into our editing module. And the very first thing we're gonna do is click on filters. This is three concentric circles on the bottom there. And you guessed it, I wanna turn this all the way to where it says mono. I think mono works the best here because it preserves all those details. Now I can just stop there and click done, and you can already see the adjustment. But now let's take the opportunity to show you exactly how we can override these settings and talk about all these adjustments that we can make on the tonal values. First one, exposure. Now this does what it sounds like. It's taking the exposure of the image and it's taking all of the tonal values and it's gonna make them either brighter or it's gonna make them darker. Now the problem that can happen though is watch what happens when I make this brighter. We're starting to lose detail, right? Look at the ceiling, for instance. That's the problem with using this exposure slider, especially when you go to extreme adjustments, is that it's not intelligent enough to protect those highlights, those brighter regions of the photo. So now that we know what exposure does, I do want to make this brighter. So I'm going to drag this up until around 40. And look at the difference just between the before and after of this one slider. Now, how do I show you that difference? If I tap on this circle here, I tap on this adjustment, it'll turn that on and off. That's where we enter our next slider here, Brilliance. So if I drag this to the right and I drag this to the left, look at what it's doing. It's giving me a little bit more contrast and it is making the image brighter or darker, but it's doing it in an intelligent way, only brightening the areas that need brightness and not brightening those already bright areas. In other words, it won't blow out the highlights or overexpose the highlights, effectively losing detail in the brightest portions of the image the way the exposure slider would. So what we're gonna do is add just a little bit of brilliance, just give it a little bit more pop in the highlights, a little bit more punch to the photo. I like to make my images as bright as possible, especially when I have white, the color white in my scene. So I'm gonna increase this to about 20 or so, right about there. I think that's looking good. And again, if I hit the circle, it's a subtle adjustment, but it is significant, isn't it? It's making a difference. It's giving me closer to what I had in mind, this vision of a very bright, a very vivid monotone image. I want those bright values to be as bright as possible until we start losing detail. Okay, moving on. Let's talk about our highlights. Now our highlights are the very brightest portion of our image. Take a look at the ceiling already specifically here. We already made this image almost as bright as possible. So we can use the highlight slider for two reasons. One, we can take the brightest part of the image and we can make it brighter. In this case, I start to lose a little bit of detail when I do. Or we can take the highlight slider to recover detail in the brightest part of the image. Just by moving the slider in the negative fashion, here you'll see I'm recovering a little bit more detail. In this scenario, for this photo, I don't actually think we need to recover the highlights or increase the brightness. I think we got the exposure pretty good using the exposure and the brilliance adjustments already. So I'm gonna leave that at zero. Next up, we have our shadows. Now this affects the darker portion of our images, what we call the dark grays or blacks. So if I drag this to the right here, look at what it does to those darker portions of the image. Now if I drag it the other way, it's gonna take those dark areas and make them darker, giving me a little bit more of a contrasty photo. Now in this scenario, what I think is gonna work quite well is if I bring this up somewhere, let's say 50, right around there. Now let me show you the before and after by tapping the circle again. There's my before and there's my after. We already have some darks there. We already have some almost pure blacks. To me, I wanna take these darker areas and make this more of what we call a high key photo or an intentionally bright photo. So moving on to contrast. Now what does contrast do? You can think of contrast as a slider that adjusts both the highlights and the shadows, those two adjustments that we just made previously, except it does it in one step. If we drag the contrast to the right, it's gonna take those brights and make them too bright, and it's gonna make those darks darker. Now if I drag it to the left, naturally what happens is we start to get a gray photo, right? Because gray is in the middle of our tonal range. The blacks are being shifted a little bit towards gray, and the whites are being shifted a little bit towards gray, so reducing the contrast. Now for me, I don't think we need to make many adjustments here. And the reason is we've already adjusted our contrast individually using the other sliders such as brilliance and exposure and shadows. So now let's move on to the next slider, brightness. This works in a similar fashion to both exposure and brilliance. If I drag to the right, it's gonna make the whole image brighter. And if I drag to the left, it's gonna make the whole image darker. Now, it's gonna do it in a slightly different way. So it's worth experimenting whether or not you like the effect of either the exposure or the brilliance slider as well. I actually like the exposure value where it is, especially in the highlights here. So I'm gonna go ahead and zero this out just like that. Now there is one last value that I do want to adjust, and that's the very darkest portion of the image, the pure blacks of the photo. And that's what this slider does, the black point. So I'm gonna drag this to the right and take a look at those windows in the corners in the top left and the top right. You'll notice that they get much darker as I drag this. Now, if I hit the circle on and off, look at the difference there. You see what I mean? It gives us contrast, but it does it only in the very, very darkest part of the image. So before I took the shadows, which are not pure blacks, they're just the darker grays of the image, and I lifted them up a little bit to give me a little bit more detail. But then I started to lose a little contrast. So you can offset that by coming over here to the black point and moving this all the way to the right, giving it just a little bit more of a pop and contrasty feel to it. Now, if I go the other way, this to me, it's almost like a film effect where we start to lose contrast, but this is what we would get if we shot with an older camera that was shooting film. We don't ever actually have a pure black. It does give us a sort of nostalgic kind of feel. But for this photo, I do think dragging the blacks all the way to the right here is gonna give me that punch and that clarity, that kind of vibrant kind of feel to this photo. So let's take a look at what we actually did here. If I tap on the screen, here's my before and here's my after. It's a very, very different photo, isn't it? This took us a little bit longer because I did have to show you what every slider does, but often this happens in a matter of seconds, right? You have this vision, you have this idea of what something could be. And if that's different from what you get when you first click the shutter, moving some of these sliders around will allow you to achieve that vision in a very simple and intuitive way. This video was a free preview of the iPhone Editing Academy online course. In this course, you'll discover everything you need to know to edit your photos to perfection using the device that's always in your pocket. Whether you want to breathe new life into your old images or make your best photos even better, you'll find out exactly how to do that on your iPhone. I'll show you the latest photo editing tricks that will transform even average photos into stunning masterpieces in just a few minutes. So if you'd like to learn more about creating incredible photo edits on your iPhone, please take a look at the full version of my iPhone Editing Academy course. You'll find the link in the description right next to this video. So click on that link now, and I'll see you inside the full version of this course.